Good afternoon, and welcome to the Peninsula Symphonic Winds Picnic and Pops 2016. Stephen Reinecke's 2002 overture, Main Street Celebration, opened the concert. James D. Ployhar's briskly executed trumpet section feature, Traveling Trumpets, followed. Should you be curious about who these swiftly moving, unshakable trumpeters are, their names are listed in the printed program. Also unshakable and listed in the printed program, our fabulous flute section. So this next feature, jazzy and playful, is titled Those Fabulous Flutes. Go figure. The bluesy theme is infectious. Your feet might fidget just a bit. Toe tapping, dancing too, is not uncommon at PSW concerts, particularly with this piece. Jack Bullock's Those Fabulous Flutes. So Bill Ehler asked me to mention to you that the printed program that I talked about earlier, very astute, Bill, thank you. They are actually located underneath the Lebanada Bay Homeowners Association tent. You guys want to wave? There they are, okay. So that's where you'll find those printed programs. We'll give you the lowdown on what's happening today. So, on with the concert. Rossini was 21 years old when, in less than 30 days, he composed an Italian in Algiers. A brief synopsis of the opera. The four main characters are Mustafa, he's called the Bey, and that means governor, for a governor of Algiers, right? He's the governor of Algiers. So Mustafa, the governor, his wife, Elvira, and of course, the Italian girl, Isabella, and her fiance, Lindoro. So here we go. In a nutshell, Mustafa is bent on capturing the heart of Isabella. However, the wife, Elvira, could be a problem. So he conjures a plan to marry Elvira, his wife, marry her off to Lindoro. Remember Lindoro, the fiance of Isabella? It's already getting complicated. However, Elvira, proving herself the wilier, manages to arrange the escape of Isabella and Lindoro while at the same time retaining the affection of her unsuspecting mate, Mustafa. Sounds good. Suitable plot for any 21st century romantic comedy. I'm into it. So from 1813, Gioachino Rossini's Overture to an Italian in Algiers. Thank you. So Gary Berkson always steps off stage for a moment at this point and catches his breath. I don't get to do that. Okay, so I've got it. My breath is back. George Gershwin was born just 30 years following Rossini's demise. And at 30 years of age, Gershwin composed his iconic symphonic poem, An American in Paris. The impression of an American visitor in Paris, strolling about the city, listening to various street noises, absorbing the French atmosphere. Bluesy elements in the piece might be read as homesickness. However, nostalgia is not a fatal disease, and our American visitor inevitably returns to the role of a dynamic spectator of Parisian life. The street noises and French atmosphere are inescapable. From 1928, George Gershwin's An American in Paris. Thank you. So today, as part of our education outreach program managed by clarinetist Karen Yokoyama, we have invited local school musicians to join us. These willing and talented young people will perform high school cadets with us, as well as the march to open the second 50% of today's concert, Bandology. So we get two pieces with the kids. I have thoroughly enjoyed working with these remarkable young people. They are Eric on oboe, Karen is presenting them with a certificate of completion, Brandon on bassoon, Renzo on trumpet, Daisy on trombone, Shayna on euphonium, and Tim on tuba. An immense thank you goes out to their school music teachers and to their ever more supportive families. So to conclude the first 50% of today's concert, we have John Philip Sousa's High School Cadets. I wanted to give you a little background on the piece while the kids get seated and situated. This perennial popular march was composed in 1890 at the request of the marching cadets at the only high school in Washington. The only high school in Washington. That's changed. Sousa was then director of the United States Marine Band, and his reputation as a march composer already well established. A new march from Sousa could help make the difference in the hotly contested marching competitions that were popular in the nation's capital since the time of the Civil War. The competitive spirit of these high school cadets went as far as to ask Sousa to please make the march superior to the one he had written 2 years earlier, entitled The National Fencibles, for a rival Washington cadet corps. Upon completion of the march, the cadets were invited to a Marine Band rehearsal where they heard the march played and, according to Sousa's autobiography, paid him the royal sum of $25 for the composition. Regarding their earlier request for a superior march, Sousa did state some 20 years later that he thought it was in fact superior to the National Fencibles, and its continued popularity supports his contention today. So John Philip Sousa's High School Cadets After We Tune Up. Thank you. That was Eric Osterlind's 1963 Concert March Bandology. Congratulations to the brave and resolute student musicians. We hope to see and hear more of you on stages throughout the South Bay and the world beyond. Thomas Kalin is a local composer and educator. He teaches middle school instrumental music in Orange County. Tom has also been a frequent guest of the PSW over the past 20 years. This next piece is one of his. Clown Act is a humorous circus march bringing to life all the color of a clown parade as it slips and slides and elbows you in the ribs. Those are Tom's words, by the way. The sax section gets to stand and bark like dogs, and the entire ensemble screams in delight as a clown is shot out of a cannon onto a galloping horse. Colorful and exciting and chock full of surprises. Hang on, it could be a bumpy ride. Clown Act. Thank you. Johnny Crespo has been playing percussion, mostly mallets, with the PSW since January of this year. Johnny earned his bachelor's degree in music composition and his master's degree in commercial music at Cal State LA. Currently, Johnny teaches at Schur High School in Montebello, where he coaches the after-school percussion ensemble. In preparation for today's solo opportunity with the PSW, Johnny had his students learn the solo part too. What a great idea. He got a little more practice in on the piece, and the students got to learn a classic virtuoso solo. Flight of the Bumblebee is an orchestral interlude written by Rimsky-Korsakov for his opera, The Tale of Tsar Saltan. The magical swan bird transforms Prince Vidan, that's Tsar Saltan's son, into an insect so that he can fly away to discreetly visit his father, who incidentally does not know that he is alive, particularly as a bumblebee. In the original orchestration, the solo part is shared. It's passed around various sections of the orchestra. Today, however, it will be a single xylophone. With considerable pleasure, the Peninsula Symphonic Winds is proud to present and join Johnny Crespo for Rimsky-Korsakov's Flight of the Bumblebee.
straight into the knee. And don't forget to sign the box. I'll just need to stop the box. See it? Hearing? Okay. And straight into the knee. Does that sound right, everybody? They're resting.
Thank you.
Thank you. Whoops. Thank you for being so receptive and enthusiastic today. Our next concert will be Sunday, October 16th, 3 o'clock, at the Rolling Hills Covenant Church Community Center on Silver Spur. The theme will be Oktoberfest. So thank you to Palos Verdes High School and Sean over there for hosting today's concert. We will finish with Spanish dances, the Pasodobles Agüero and España Cañé. In case you haven't noticed, playing music is great fun for us. We hope you've had fun and you've enjoyed today's performance. Have a relaxing and enjoyable summer. See you for Oktoberfest.
Thank you.
Yes, we do have an encore for you. Owl Cities, I'll say that again, Owl City, O-W-L, Owl Cities, 2009 Fireflies. In composer Adam Young's words, Fireflies is a little song about bugs and not being able to fall asleep at night. The lyrics reflect on insomnia, fireflies, and summer. So thank you again for spending this splendid summer Sunday afternoon with the Peninsula Symphonic Winds. Fireflies.
Thank you.